everyone, hope all is well today. My name is Gilles Lamotte. Today we'll be working with the binomial and the normal distributions. Firstly, I would like to show you how to write comments in R. So at the prompt, we will put a pound, and following the pound are simply comments that R will not interpret. So for example, let's say that I want to work with the binomial distribution. I'll tell you that X has a binomial distribution, and then I continue with another pound with n equal to 30, let's say, so we'll have 30 independent trials, and then the probability of success out of 12 will be 75%. So this tells me, or gives me some information concerning the binomial. Now, let's say that I want to compute, so again I'll put a comment, I want to compute the probability that X is equal to 20. And so inside of R, there is an R name for the distribution. It's called binom. And then what we're going to do is we're going to prefix binom with either a D or a P. So the D will give us the probability mass function. So let's say that I want to compute the probability that X is equal to 20, and so I'm going to use D. So prefix binom with D, and then I'll put 20 to say that I want the probability that my binomial will be equal to 20, and then I need to give the values of the parameter, the parameters of the distribution. So we will set n equal to 30, and then p will be equal to 0.75. So following the order, first parameter is n, second parameter is p. And then as I enter the command, then the probability that X will be equal to 20 is about 9%. Let's say I want to compute the probability X is equal to 21, so then I would simply write in 21 into the first argument. Okay. Generally, we're not interested necessarily into the probability of just one value. Maybe we want the probability of that X will take on the values between 20 and 25 inclusively. So let's say I write a comment and I say that we want the probability of X being between 20 and 25. And so what we could do is actually evaluate the binomial, or the probability mass function for the binomial, at each one of the values between 20 and 25 inclusively. So I could use D binom. And then if I use 20 with a colon 25, what this is going to do is going to create a vector 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. And then at each one of these values for this vector, R is going to compute the probability mass function for the binomial. I'm going to tell R which binomial, so I want n equal to 30 and p equal to 0.75. And so here we see that R is actually computing the binomial for n for number of successes equal to 20, number of successes equal to 21, and so on. Now, we actually want to add up these probabilities, and so I'll put my dbinom command inside of a sum command, and this is going to add up all of the probabilities. Okay, so this is how we use the probability mass function inside of R, which is called dbinom. We could also use the CDF, the cumulative distribution function. So R can accumulate probabilities from 0 right up to a certain number of successes of interest. So let's say that I want to accumulate the probabilities for the binomial from 0 to 25. And so the prefix in this case would be P. So I'll just write this. P is the prefix for the CDF. And so what we'll do is I'll write pbinom, and then I'll put in the value. Let's say I want 25. Again, the same binomial, so n equal to 30, p equal to 0.75, and then this will give me the probabilities for a number of successes from 0, 1, 2, 3, right up to 25. Now, let's say that we're really interested in the probability of the number of successes are between 20 and 25 inclusively. So what we want are really just the probability masses for 20, 21, 22, right up to 25. pbinom gives us the masses for 0, 1, 2, 3, right up to 25. So what we'll do is we'll take away the masses for the values that we don't want. And so I don't want the masses for 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 19. And then as I do this difference, I see that I get the same value as before. So 0, almost, or 80% is a probability that my binomial will be between 20 and 25 inclusively. Okay, so just to recap, binom is the R name. You put a prefix in front of the R name, either D to get the probability mass function or P to get the cumulative distribution function. Okay, so this is the binomial. Let's say that we are also interested in working with a normal distribution. And so again, I'll put a comment. So now I'm going to say that X has a normal distribution. I'm going to put another comment to give the mean. So with mean, let's say that we use a mean of 25. And then I put another comment, a standard deviation of 5.25. Okay, so these are just comments to give some information about my normal distribution. And now let's say that we want to compute the probability that my normal distribution would be less than 20. Okay, so I'll put a comment, we want the probability that the normal random variable is less than 20. And so the R name for the normal, so R name, is norm. And again, we're going to use a prefix to get the cumulative distribution function. And so the prefix is P for CDF. And so I put P norm. And then I want the probability of being smaller than 20. And so then I need to give the values of parameters. It's going to be the mean first and then a standard deviation. So I have a mean of 25, a standard deviation of 5.25. And then as I enter the command, this is the probability that my normal with a mean of 25 and a standard deviation of 5.25 is less than 20. So this is about 17%. Okay. Let's say that we want to find a probability that this normal random variable would fall between 20 and 25. And so I could get the probability of it being smaller than 25, take away the probability of it being smaller than 20, and then we end up with the probability of this normal being between 20 and 25. Okay, so this is the CDF for the normal. Often we're also interested in getting quantiles, and so what we want to do is, for example, find the fifth percentile for a particular normal distribution. And so the prefix in this case would be Q. Q is for quantile. And so what I'll do is I'll modify an old command. I'll change the P for a Q. So Q norm. So I want to get a quantile from this normal distribution. First argument will be a probability. So here, let's say I want to find the fifth percentile, so I put 5%, so 0.05. Same normal, so a mean of 25, standard deviation of 5.25. And as I enter this, this is a value for my random variable. So 5% of the values for this normal distribution would be smaller or equal to 16.36. Okay, so this is the fifth percentile for this normal distribution. Maybe I want the 95th percentile, so 95% of the values for this normal distribution would be smaller than this. So I get a 33.6 about. And then this would mean what? So it would mean that 90% of my values from this distribution fall somewhere between 16.36 and 33.63. Okay, let's say that we want to find the first quartile and the third quartile. What this means is the 25th percentile and the 75th percentile. So if I put 0.25, I end up with 21.4 about, or almost 21.5. I put 75% in my first argument, and then I end up with the third quartile or the 75th percentile. Okay. Now, let's say that I want to find the interquartile range. So this is the distance between the 25th percentile and the 75th percentile. So half of the values from this normal distribution would reside between them. And so since R can work like a computer, I can do a difference. So what I'll do is I'll ask for the 75th percentile, take away the 25th percentile, and we end up with 7.08. So this is the interquartile range. So half of the values from this normal distribution would reside in an interval of length about 7.08 units. Alright, so that's it for today. This is how you work with the normal and binomial distributions. Just to recap, for the normal, you put the prefix of P to get the CDF, a prefix of Q to get quantiles, so quantities from a normal distribution that satisfy a certain probability. Alright, so thank you. Have a good day.